Dependency injection is a programming technique that makes it easy to manage and share resources between different components of your application. In this video, we will explore dependency injection in the context of Flutter using the GetIt library. Let me give you some great news. You can join our Flutter community on Telegram. Simply join this group to stay in contact with other Flutter developers, to learn from each other, and to become a better Flutter developer. So don't forget and join now. Why use dependency injection with GetIt? Low coupling. It makes separation of concerns easier, making components easier to test, maintain, and extend. Easy to use. GetIt offers a minimalist API for dependency injection. And flexibility. GetIt allows different type of registration like Singleton and factory. First, let's start by showing a common problem that can happen without dependency injection in a software application. Then, we will solve the problem using the GetIt package in Dart, which is a popular dependency injection library. Imagine you are building a Flutter app and you have a class called AppService responsible for handling user data. Now, you need to use it in various parts of your app. In one page called Homepage and other details page. The problem is you will need to create instance of AppService in each class you need it, like this. And if you have more than 10 pages which need this class, you are going to create a new instance each time. This approach works, but it has some cons, like if you decide later to change implementation of your service, it will be complex. And you can have errors. So, how we can avoid this by using dependency injection with GetIt? Before we start, let's make it clear. There are three main ways to register a service with GetIt. Register a factory. It means that every time you request your service object, GetIt will create a new instance of it for you. Register a singleton. You create a new instance of your service class at the time you register it with GetIt. Then, GetIt always gives you that same instance back. This is useful when you want to keep the state of some service. Register a lazy singleton. You register your service class, but GetIt doesn't actually create an instance of it until you request it for the first time. Let's first create a file called app_service.dart. We are going to create a class called AppService and create execute function which will return current date time. This class is just an example, but it could have been an API service class. In the next step, I create a new file called injection_container.dart. Here, we will be registering all the instances under one method and call it from main before calling run app to make sure every instance is registered before the app starts. Next, import GetIt package. Now, the first thing we need to do here is to define instance of GetIt. To do this, we can use getit.instance. We are defining the service locator instance globally so that we can access it anywhere in the application. The reason why I named it as locator is because it provides a centralized location or locator for managing service locators and dependency injection in a Flutter application. Now I define a method called setup. The setup method is the place where we register all our services. First, I want to register the app service class as a singleton. To do this, it is enough to use the register singleton method and pass the instance we want to register. This is very simple. I print here something like this so that instance registration is clear. And now go back to the main file. Here, as I said, we must call the setup method before the run app. Now we can remove these instances that we created. Well, I want to call the execute method using GetIt when it clicks on the GetDate button. For this, we just need to use the locator and pass the instance to it, and then call the desired method. As you can see, it is working well and there is no problem. If you remember, we registered the app service as a singleton. This means that GetIt always gives us that same instance back. This is useful when you want to keep the state of some services. In order to test this and find out if it is really registered as a singleton or not, it is enough to print something in the constructor of the AppService class. Now this text should be printed only once when we register the AppService, and when we click on the button, it should not be printed. As you can see, when I click on the button, the text is not printed, and in fact, the AppService is not initialized again, and it was initialized only once during registration. Now I want to register the AppService as Lazy Singleton. As I explained, in Lazy Singleton, GetIt doesn't actually create an instance of AppService until we request it for the first time. This means that the text that is printed in the constructor should be printed when the button is clicked and not printed when the setup method is called. To register as a Lazy Singleton, it is enough to use the register Lazy Singleton method like this. Now I restart the app, and now when I click on the button, the text should be printed. As you can see, the text is printed, and if I click the button again, the text is not printed. This means that the app service is registered as a Lazy Singleton, and it is initialized only when we use the app service for the first time. We can use register Lazy Singleton if we have some services that don't need to be initialized during the runtime of the app. This is more memory efficient. And finally, I want to register the app service as a factory. In the factory, every time we want to use the app service, GetIt will create a new instance of it. So every time I click on the button, the text in the app service constructor is printed. And this means that GetIt create a new instance of the app service every time. I have explained the basics of dependency injection to you. You should definitely use it in your application. See you in the next video.